So, yeah, cruise ships have really kind of come on hard time with this whole thing, and, you know, people aren't able to go out. But one of the most popular videos, actually the most popular video on my YouTube channel, was a piece that we did when we did Port of Opportunity. And we were on a cruise ship, Port of Baltimore, and spent some time with the captain up on the bridge and spent some time down in the galley. So we're going to take a little visit on the cruise ship.
You could say that I have the overall responsibility for everything that's good and everything that's bad. So in general, you could say that I have a finger in absolutely everything that works on board. But naturally, since I'm a captain, my main responsibility is the safety and security of the people. If they are navigating in a safe manner, go from A to B in a safe manner, and make sure that people have a comfortable ride, as I used to call it. Altogether on this ship, we are approximately 800 crew members, and that is for the entire operation. If you're on a cargo ship, you're on a ship with maybe 20 people. If you're on a cruise ship, you're on a ship with several thousand people. It is more challenging in many, many ways, but it's also very giving. I guess you were expecting a big wheel, but it's just a small, tiny wheel you can use with one hand or one finger. And we are using that. Quartermasters are steering. They can read up here and also here how the rudders are. We have two rudders on board here, and we can use them independently, or we can use them paired together. You can say normally we use them paired together, but in given situations, then we are using them individually. But when we are doing it individually, using them, for instance, during a maneuver, then I'm taking control over there at the main console. I have my friend here, Fritz the Monkey. And the reason for that I have Fritz the Monkey here is that there are so many things to take care of. If I go back here to this conning station, I used to say, here is one monkey, here is two monkeys. And then I had the thrusters, three monkeys, four monkeys, five monkeys, and then I have the rudders, six monkeys. And the more monkeys I have on my back, the more difficult it is. And it's very important that when you are dealing with all this stuff, that you manage to keep the simplicity and also keep the basics in what you're doing. Because what you are dealing with there, despite all the electronics, it all comes down to physics. And it is so important that you never forget that. And that is maybe one of the reasons why you can't just sit and play video games and then start to do this. You really need to have an understanding of what's going on in order to operate it.
When you go on a cruise, food is everything. So please meet our chef.
I started my career 17 years back home in India. I came on board with the conception that I have to move forward because every day it was challenging. And it took me all these years to cover up, and I gained more knowledge, got my promotions, got myself certified. I'm here right now today doing 17 years, and it's fascinating. Every day, as I said, it's more knowledge, more experience, and that's something keeps you going. It's a passion, and what I love to do is more about teaching the people, giving my experience and passing it to them, and they feel happy about it. And that's how we work together here, like a little family, cruising all the way, learning different things every day. We have three production galleys. This is deck number four, as we call it, the main production galley. In this galley on board the Grandeur, we got 76 cooks. That includes our chef de parties, our chefs. I'm assisted with one executive sous chef, and I have four sous chefs who are overseeing in terms of management, looking after the operation. We have two pastry chefs in our pastry shop and a team of seven professional pastry culinarians who are doing their best on a daily basis. And here I am doing a little bit of sort of a tasting. I'm making arrabbiata sauce. Arrabbiata sauce, we're just simmering nice succulent tomatoes in some nice olive oil with a shaved garlic. Well, we have a special lunch coming up very soon. So that's how we use always disposable spoons to do our tasting. Wow, hey chef, this is a little bit of a touch of salt over here and touch of some fresh basil through before we just take it out. And that's what makes good food and really tasteful, and you can really bring this experience and the taste to the table where our guests are dining. And here we are moving forward. We're coming down to our pastry shop. which is, we always call on board, the sweetest thing on board. And you can see tonight we have for our dinner Boston cream pie. As you can see, they are stuffed up with rum, and then they are all decorated with our chocolate ganache with a trail of some white chocolate on top of it. And you see our pastry chef, who's a new hire. As you can see them, they're wearing a yellow scarf to identify that they're new hires on board, which is a good tool for us to identify and teach them what is right and what is wrong. So here he goes with his sharpest knife, cutting the Boston cream pie. Part of my job responsibility is also to check the fresh produce which comes on board, especially something that is more perishable and gets spoiled towards the end. I would check the quality of the fresh herbs and the berries which come on board. And we have our provision master, Mr. Elton, always assists us in delivering all the products and assisting my team up here. And we always work together, ensuring we have the right amount of commodity on board to cater to 2,400 guests and to ensure that we have it lasting all the way for 8-day cruise.